everybody, it's Wilson, and I have a question for you. Do you ever feel like, as a real estate agent, you're always running in circles, and by the end of the day, there's still so much work for you to be able to do, and you don't know if you're going in the right direction? Today, we're gonna talk about how I manage my time block, and how I think about my day to make sure that I could say I succeeded every day. Because the day-to-day needs to tie to your end goal, which you will define as whether it's helping X amount of families every year, making X amount of money, spending only 8 or 6 hours per day to make sure that you're succeeding and you're obviously still spending time personally. And I'm going to give you 3 tips and also maybe a bonus so that it should help you in measuring your daily success and get you on track to reaching your goals in real estate. Tip number 1. Working in the business versus on the business. Now I'm gonna take a page from the 7 habits of highly effective people. Imagine we're in a forest and we're working together. We're chopping trees down and we're working hard at it and we're really good at what we do. However, working on the business is having that person up above in the canopy, making sure we're going in the right direction because it's the end of the day and we need to know where we're headed. That's the difference between working in versus on the business. In the business, we need to hone our skills, we need to service clients, we need to do what we need to do on a day-to-day basis. But how do we know we're improving ourselves? How do we know we're going in the right direction towards our goals? We need to think higher level to know where we're headed. And that's in versus on the business. Tip number 2. There's a lead generation and marketing side of the business, and there's also the servicing side of the business. You could be a very good service-oriented person, but if you're never going to look for business, there's nobody to service. So actually, the first shop, which is you building and strengthening relationships that you have to get them to the point of saying, I have a need, I wanna buy, I wanna sell, whatever the service is, get agreement, meeting of the minds, and eventually you have to service them. And of course, at that point, offering value, you get compensated for it. And that's tip number 2. Tip number 3 is the 80-20 rule, Pareto's principle. If you don't know that already, I'm gonna share a little bit more. You will always have 100 tasks that you feel like you're obligated to in a day, and that's why we're gonna feel very lost, because in a day, you cannot complete everything. There's a never-ending amount of work. However, that's where prioritization comes into play, and it's super important. Here's what I mean. The day before your next workday, create a list of everything you need to do. I know I said 100, let's make it more reasonable. Let's say there's 10 priorities for you to do the next day. Write those 10 out and prioritize them to make sure that you focus on a top 3 to 5. If you have a little bit of leverage in your life, delegate the rest. But you should be focused on a task with your energy and time that will yield the best results for you and give you a return on your time. And that's 80-20 principle. And here's the bonus of the video. You kind of heard me say it already. It is prioritizing your time, focusing on the right activities, and delegating the rest. But when you are focused on those activities, you should forward your calls, forward your emails, put your phone on silent, make sure you don't have any distractions, because oftentimes we want to focus, but our environment doesn't create that. And we get thrown off by responding to a text message. Someone calls us. We get a ping for an email. And that's when there's distractions in your task switching. It's gonna take your energy and willpower to get back on track. To avoid that, the tip is forward your calls, forward your emails, have someone else take care of it if you have leverage in your life. If not, create a new voicemail telling people that you're at an appointment, typically between these hours, and that you'll get back to them within the same day. Thank you so much for watching this video. We hope you found this helpful. If you have any other questions, you're always welcome to reach out. You can comment below, or you can probably find my email or phone number. Follow us on Instagram at Wilson, WLREA, or our business page at WLREA. If you have any questions for other team members, because we do have a larger operation with specialists, as we said, feel free to reach out to them too. We run a completely transparent business, and we want to be able to share what we've learned through our experiences. Thank you so much.